Hey, what's going on, team? It's Ricky with Tech But Solutions. Hope that you guys are all having an amazing Tuesday. I wanted to change things up a little bit. What an amazing day, right? We see the overall NASDAQ market absolutely killing it. Tech as a whole is in the green and very grateful for it, right? We've been talking about this. We've been preparing for this. This is why we buy the dip. Right, we don't buy the dip on very cheap and risky stocks. I mean, you can, it just, that's a different story. But when it comes down to these like quality companies, this is why we prepare when the market pulls back, because there's a load of deals, right? We see that TQQQ is up 9% today. We have Urban Outfitters up 3% today. AMC is up 8% today. Overall NASDAQ index, 3% today. Tesla, 4%. PayPal, 3%. Pinterest, 3%. Zillow, 2%. Snapchat, 6%. Comment down below, what stock were you invested in and how much is it up today? We absolutely killed it. And one of the things that I quickly want to talk about is, yes, I did average up into my positions that I'm intending to swing trade for a longer period of time. Facebook, I doubled my position today. TQQQ on my Fidelity account, doubled my position today. I am so excited for these, you know, stocks that I see value in to recover as the NASDAQ market recovers. Another stock that I traded, and yes, traded, I'm not gonna hold a bunch of it overnight, is AMC. AMC is up 8% on the day, and as you guys can see, I'm up over $10,000. This was all caught within today's live trading session. I wanna explain to you why I'm not holding AMC. I'm not here to encourage you to hold it. I'm not here to encourage you not to hold it. I just want you to understand my thought process. I don't like to hold AMC, and right now it's actually pushing up, so I'm gonna add an additional 500 shares. I like trading AMC intraday. The reason why is because I view AMC to be a risky trade, right? It moves a lot, just as much as it could gap up 10% in one day. I've seen it drop 15, 20%. That's a risky stock. That's a volatile stock. With that being said, I also see a lot of potential, which is why I trade it so often. But my main focus, especially with a lot of beginners watching, is risk management. So I do hold, and I feel comfortable holding a number of shares overnight, but just a fraction of what I would normally trade with. I'm okay with trading AMC with $120,000, $150,000. I'm okay with that. I can do that all day. I can day trade AMC all day with $150,000, $200,000. But why? Well, I can manage my risk intraday, right? So if it's bullish, like right now, right? It pulled back, it bounced at the moving average, it's indicating signs of a recovery, I can trade it. I right now have $47,000 invested. I can buy, right now we're trading above the EMA, so I'll buy another 500 shares. So now I have $62,000 invested in AMC. And as it becomes overbought, I will sell it. I will lock in profits, and I will continue to do that as it continues to indicate signs of an uptrend. I can lock in profits, and if things go south, I can manage my risk. Now, let me tell you why I don't want to hold $150,000 worth of AMC overnight. Because if it crashes 5, 10, 15% overnight, if AMC pulls back, I don't want to have $150,000. So I can reap the benefit of AMC being bullish intraday, and I can day trade it. I can take advantage of all of that, right? All of that opportunity. But if AMC begins to pull on back, I can quickly exit and manage my risk within the same day. If I hold it overnight, I can't control where it opens at. So if it opens down 5%, 10%, 15%, I take on all of that risk. But you are correct, right? What if it gaps up 15%? I do miss out on that. I would rather miss out on an opportunity than to put myself in a worse position, right? That's the whole purpose of risk management. If you're someone that's okay with holding it, all power to you. But if you're someone that's asking the question, why would I rather day trade something versus hold something or hold a lot of it overnight? It's all about risk management and position size. Put yourself in a position to succeed. Don't always just think about the upside potential and how much more money you can make, but always take into consideration risk management. It's one of the most common mistakes, and you'll see people in the comment section. It's one of the most common mistakes beginner traders make, or people who lack experience. They don't understand that. They're like, well, just hold it. You don't lose money until you sell. Well, technically no, right? If it goes back down to zero, it gets delisted. You're gonna have to sell at whatever price it gets delisted at. So that mentality just expresses how naive you might be when it comes down to trading in the stock market. I like taking advantage of risky stocks, but I like doing it in a tasteful way. I like doing it in a way that makes sense to me, that yes, I can make some money, $10,000, right? We're almost at $10,500, but as well as I'm not afraid to lock in profits, never. I wanna do what's best for my future self. When I trade a stock, when I trade any stock, my focus is not what other people are doing, what makes sense to other people. It's what makes sense to me and what makes sense to my future self. I need to make sure that I don't obsess about a small, minute number that I make up in my head of how much more I could have made, when in reality, my focus is to be consistent and to be consistent in the stock market. That's what's important. My actions today are what determine where I'll be in the future, right? And the only way that I can get there is if I, again, manage risk and manage my position size. So I'm very excited to follow up with it. I just want to let you guys know, I intend to hold about 1,000 shares of AMC overnight. That's still quite a bit of money. That's about $30,000. Just in case it pulls on back, I can tolerate that. But I don't want to pretend like I'm going to hold a lot more than I am, right? I wanted to show you, right? I want to show you how much it is that I'm trading, how much it is that I intend to hold. And I like to be open with you guys, right? So you guys can comment down below any thoughts. We caught the live trading session today, and it caught all of us. If you guys want to see what it's like to watch me trade live, I'm going to link the video in the description. So the first link in the description, you will see what it's actually like that led to this successful trade and what it's like to watch me trade live. So it's not just like, oh, like what happened? It's not just, you know, the profit, but you can see the trades that I took, when I began to buy, when I began to sell, and what went behind the thought process behind this successful trade. So other than that, let me know in the comment section what you guys think, what you're most excited for when it comes down to market recovery. All I know is that as long as the market stays consistent, today was a really green day. So tomorrow, expect it to either be a break even and or maybe a little bit red, right? Because today was a very, very big day for the market. We have this saying within our Learn Plan Profit group: on my green days, I prepare for the red days. And on my red days, I prepare for the green days. It is so important to understand that you're not invincible and that you're only as good as your next trade. It doesn't matter how much I made yesterday or the week before that. Every trade presents its new challenges. So make sure that you understand that. So I really do appreciate you guys' time. I hope that I earned your thumbs up. I hope to see you tomorrow for our live trading session. And if you're ready to join our Learn Plan Profit team, if you like what you saw within that live trading session, then again, I have a coupon down below. It's $50 off. It's for the first 5 people, $50 off the Learn Plan Profit 2.0. And yes, that does give you lifetime access to being able to watch me trade live every single day at market open. Until then, like always, let's make sure that we end the year on a green note. Take it easy, team.